What's going on, guys? I'm ArmadilloMC here today, and I am bringing you, well, a brand new episode. Well, episode, video. As I said on my last video, I will be doing a Minecraft 1.9, as you can see down here in the bottom left. Minecraft 1.9, like, playthrough. It will be, like, a long video, but, like, won't be, like, a big series, like a Let's Play. So, Minecraft 1.9. Not survival. So this is basically just exploring all the new features in 1.9, and the goal is to defeat the Ender Dragons. So there we go. That's good. Done. And nothing much there has changed. So we'll get straight into the game here and hopefully get some of this done. Alright, so when I actually end up uploading this, I might have to split it into two parts, because otherwise, like, depending on how long this whole video goes for, it might just be, like, way too long to upload as one video, so it might end up becoming a mini-series, so, yeah. So, Minecraft 1.9, like, came out on Tuesday, which is basically Wednesday for me, and, yeah. So we're using the default textures for my skin probably won't load. I don't know what's happening with that, whether skins are working or not right now, but you know. Alright, so we've got taking inventory, getting wood. We'll probably chop down the rest of this tree, and then we'll go for a little bit of a jog, get out the area. We really don't want to die here, because that will just set the video back a lot, especially towards the end. So we're going to make sure that when we actually do, you know, fight the Ender Dragon and stuff, look at the sounds, that we are, like, fully prepared, because I know that the Ender Dragon has gotten some serious buffs, so we're gonna have to be pretty careful of that. So yeah. Alright, let's just, music and sound, turn the music down a bit, seems a little bit loud, personally, so, grab some wood. The axe seems to be really slow at chopping wood, maybe it's just because it's a wooden axe, and I haven't used wooden tools forever. Alright, so we'll grab this here up. Alright, so we, obviously, you probably won't have diamonds when we go to fight the Ender Dragon. Hopefully we might have a diamond sword, or if I get enough diamonds, I'll go for a chest plate or something. Right, so this is basically, like, we're going to be playing basically like UHC, like, trying not to take any damage at all, and yeah. Alright, so, unfortunately we did not get any leather there, which would have been really nice to have. Sweet. Okay, we'll go over here, grab some more sugar cane. So, as you can see, PvP has changed. There's now a cooldown on, like, each hit. You can no longer right-click with a sword. You can dual-wield stuff, so if I go over here, hit F, I can dual wield my pickaxe, hit F again, and it dual wields it. So that is really cool. I like that feature a lot. We've got probably enough wood, which should be good, so. That sounded really weird, but yeah. So, give me a second, I need to do something, and I'll be right back. Alright guys, and we're back now, so, just had to fix that up, and, so, yeah. Hopefully that will remove some of the background noise, which is nice. Just because this, playing for this long is going to make my computer really noisy in the end, and having to load all the chunks, and that sort of stuff, so. Oops, grab this here up. Oh, my sprint key is not set up. Options, controls. Oh, sprint. Sprint. Said. Done. Said. Done. Oh. Don't have enough food. Okay, so we're going to... here's some stone. Right, we want to get into the caves before night time. Up until that stage, we'll probably want to stay outside for as long as possible because we want to get as much like surface resources as we can before we have to go down into the caves. However, I might start starving to death here soon if I don't go into the caves, so... Okay, so I believe up until diamond tools, axes are actually the best because their cooldown is a lot less than that of swords, and for some reason they have a load of attack damage. Or at least that's what it says right here. So it might just be like a bug or something. I'm not entirely sure. So yeah. Alright, we're getting a little bit of a little bit of leather here and there, which is good. That's what we want. Is it just me, or is the baby rabbit's gotten smaller? Because that baby rabbit looks extremely small. I never really paid too much attention to the rabbits of old, but... pretty sure they were bigger than that. Okay, so keep running here a bit. There's a cave here. Actually, no, I think it's just like surface stone. Alright, let's go. Boom. Boom. Keep crit hitting the cows. One hit kills, which is good. Oh, some lava down here. Oh, yes, iron. Okay, so. Start up a little base camp sort of thing here. Chuck this down. We'll make a stone pickaxe and four. Sweet, getting an upgrade. Mine up the iron. Right, so go. And also, like, because 1.9 just came out, I'm going to be trying to like change a lot of the ways I play Minecraft. So I'm going to try and reduce the amount of scroll wheel I use and get better at using hotkeys, because hotkeys are like literally the way to go in my beliefs, but it's just been really hard to relearn Minecraft and haven't really been giving it much time and stuff. So now that the new update's out, there's a whole bunch of new stuff to learn. Like, you have to basically relearn PvP, so I should hopefully be able to have a chance at everything new and improved. Alright, so... oh, that could have ended really bad. Okay, so we also want to save up as much levels as we can, because we want to get an enchant table. Let me rephrase that. We have to get an enchant table before we go fight the Ender Dragon, because otherwise we'll be just walking into a fight dead, basically. Okay, food, that's nice. We're not going to smelt too much up here. Alright, so also the regen has changed quite a bit, actually. Now when you eat, it regens to 8 health automatically, like, not automatically, but super fast, which is amazing. So, to 8 hearts, I'm pretty sure. And then it stops, and then you just regen at the old pace, which is alright. Like, it's a nice feature, and it's, I think, like, it's like regen 1.5, so it's not quite the speed of regen 2, but it's not regen 1, it's faster than regen 1. Okay then, so there's more lava and stuff down there, so we might want to go down there. We'll have to make some torches and stuff, because I don't have camo or anything. Just straight vanilla Minecraft. And I also stopped using gamma a long while ago. This might get a little bit laggy too towards the end, so I might have to make some cuts here and there to hopefully do some things to reduce the lag. Because I believe Minecraft 1.9 is actually laggier than 1.8, so... Okay, so here we go. Options, video settings, VBOs off, max frame rate, I'll drop this down to 30, done. I kind of feel like it's lying to me, and I'm lagging, like, a lot. And for some reason my frames aren't fluctuating or anything. And don't think that's probably a good sign, so... I don't feel like that's a good sign, so yeah. Anyhow, we'll just keep going here, and hopefully this cave is semi-decent. Yes, this is looking better. I'm hearing some weird sounds, which is scaring me. Ooh, lava. That's definitely a witch. I'm hearing some. Lava's definitely diminishing faster. That's for sure. Probably should not have built this area out of dirt. I mean, wood. Forgot that wood burns. Okay, that's bad. That's bad. Okay, I want to get out of here as fast as possible. Okay, that there's not good. And these random sounds are starting to annoy me. Alright, let's get out of here. I feel like I'm just going to mine out into, like, a bunch of witches. Whoa, okay. That was scary. Oops. Come on. Let's get out of here. Boom. Boom. Okay, not sure what is up there. And I don't know if these are just normal cave sounds, or if they are actually witches. But they're freaking me out. We might have to go witch hunting. Alright, I'll just turn frames off, because that's not helping at all. It's like not changing... I will grab a little bit more coal, because, you know, the more the better. So, brewing, I believe, has also changed. We now need blaze powder to power the actual smelting process. Which is interesting. Right, sounds like it's coming straight from over here. There. I think I discovered it. Okay, I thought that I was not actually going to be able to kill it, because, like, every two hits, it was able to drink a health pot, but... I think I'm good. Oh, getting out of there. Good. Okay, so the creeper just blew up the witch for me, which was very nice of him. Oh, there's a potion. What sort of potion? Instant health. Would have been really handy for our mining if it was in, fire res for 6 or 8 minutes, but you know. Either one works just as effective. Alright, there we go. We're collecting, smelting up the iron now. Alright, we'll just run through here quickly. Dropping down torches. So that mobs can't spawn whilst we're waiting for the iron to spawn. Smelt. And then we actually might have to turn our cords on soon to check what Y level we're at. Sorry, Z. Y. Yeah, Y is height, X is one way and Z's the other. Alright, so 47. We're going to want to go down to like 12, so we've got, you know, 35 more blocks or so to go. Alright, so finish mining up this here iron and we'll chuck in the furnace. Oh, some more. And we'll collect the other iron we've got there smelted. And yeah, also the skeletons have changed, so I have already done a little bit of exploring in 1.9, and skeletons have changed. They now don't always have like arrows on their bows, or wait, I don't think they ever had arrows on their bows. So now they only have arrows on their bows when they're about to shoot, and they also draw like their bow back and stuff. So that's cool. Make a chest plate. Sweet. Armor has been nerfed, I'm pretty sure, so we have to be careful. We won't be able to absorb as much damage and all that sort of stuff, so oops, we didn't get that coal. Oh well, we'll just break our pick here on getting more cobblestone. The more the better. Alright, so we'll now get a pickaxe. And let's see, can we find anything to kill and use up the durability on our axe? And we'll just get an iron axe for our weapon, just because the speed is faster than swords, I'm pretty sure. And as you we'll do some testing, because I'm not sure. It says 0.9, but look, if you swing this and then swing this, that there's so much slower. So I think that the larger the value is, the the quicker it is. And I just died. That was definitely not good. We definitely went down into a mine over here somewhere. I remember crossing to the other side, then we crossed backwards. We'll just keep running here. Oops. Okay, that is not good, guys. I'm sorry. I tried to take on the skeleton, but the lag and a mixture of everything else was not good, and I tried to spam click it, which did not help either. Right, so here we go. Lava. Pretty sure this here is where we went down. Which way did we go? Is there any way to that this here joins back up? How did he follow me for so long? Oh my lord. Alright, let's try this again. And if I can't get back this time, I'll have to make a quick cut and get back our gear. Okay, so keep going. We are going to Alright, let's go. Sprint. Sprint, sprint, sprint. Sprint. Alright. I think we got away from the spider. Like, these mob tracking, like, it's changed a lot. That zombie was able to follow me down the entire thing, which I don't believe it would have used to be able to. Like, if that was a normal zombie, he would have been lost 3 times. Please don't tell me that's the same zombie that managed to find its way out as well. Alright, let's go. Go down. Ouch. Boom. I think I wasted like most of the wood there. Ouch. That should not have set me on fire. Alright, so then we go up here. Find out that's the dead end. Come back down. Here. Here we go. Up, up, and away we go. This way. Here we go. All our stuff is still here. Unfortunately, we lost a bit of levels, but that's okay. So, as you can see, the mobs definitely have gotten better, and yeah. That skelly was mad. Alright, so let's continue on here. We'll collect our iron. We'll put the stuff and things back in there to smelt. We'll actually get full iron armor here because, well, I don't want to die again. That armor did like nothing also to protect me, so the nerfing of the armor is definitely real. Unfortunately. Okay, so we'll chuck that there. So this is 0.9 and 9. Yeah, so the higher it is, the faster it is, I suppose. So this is 1.6. This is 0.9. This is 6 damage, and this does 9 damage. So I'm not really sure. So yeah, cause boom, oops, boom, boom, boom. Whereas the axe will be like boom, boom. Yep. So I'm pretty sure the sword is going to be better, cause it's almost got twice the like speed. So maybe they're like identical. I'm not like I basically have no clue. So yeah. Just doing some quick, like, maths in my head. They're going to be pretty similar in most regards, so. Alright, so regen, poison definitely has slowed down. How about regen? Okay, so the regen does work against poison, which is definitely good. As you can see, I was regening super fast. Like, no potion effects or anything. That's just normal vanilla regen now. Which is decently nice, I suppose. Alright, we'll grab that. And then, I suppose we need to start heading down to diamond level. So, we need to find a way down. We'll actually grab some more coal. Yeah, I've only got a little bit left of that stuff, so. There's also these, like, blue XP orbs now. Which, I don't know if that's just a visual glitch, and they're meant to still be yellow, or what. Because this is just vanilla Minecraft textures. Which is cool. And as you can see, swapping between, like, tools and weapons and stuff has slowed down, like, a decent amount, so. Because, like, you can no longer quickly hotkey to your sword and kill a mob. You have to hotkey to your sword, wait a couple seconds, and then you can start hitting it. So, that's very interesting. I believe knockback now is going to be super nice, handy to have. Because you'll be able to knock the mobs back whilst your sword or axe or whatever it is like, you know, replenishes and is ready to hit again. Where were we just a second ago where we found the witch? Because I think I might want to follow that path. It seemed like it may have gone down some eventually. Not entirely sure. Here we go. This here might work. 2 iron, damn it. Just going to craft a bucket, but I don't suppose we will. And pick up the water, because when mining, it's always a good idea to have a bucket of water on you. Because you never know what you might stumble across. We'll pick up the iron. The more iron, the better. We'll need an anvil eventually anyway, so that requires 46 iron, I believe. Don't hold me to that, I'm not entirely sure. I was just guessing, basically. But we could do the math. Not that I don't think anyone wants to. But there's 3 blocks, all off 9, that equals 27. And there's 4 on the bottom, which means it's 31. So you need 31 iron to make an anvil. Honestly, I don't even know if the anvil crafting recipe is the same still or not. And see, now that's why we need the bucket. Alright, we'll grab all that stuff out here. Drop that there, back into the smelting bench, whatever you want to call it. And we'll explore, actually. Boom, boom. Make a shovel. 5. And we'll start collecting some flint, I suppose. Because we're going to need flint for arrows when we fight the Ender Dragons, so. That's 2 flint already. Let's just keep going along. Alright, so let's continue getting some flint. Also, sorry if I don't talk too much. It's going to get pretty hard talking for like an hour or two straight without having stopped. So I got my water here, so. A nice Nike water bottle, always handy. We actually also will need feathers then eventually to craft arrows. We might have to go chicken hunting when we go back up, and then we also have to go to the Nether, which so that we can get the blaze powder. Then we have to fight like a lot of endermen. Or we might end up just, you know, skipping the finding the end part, and we'll just like make an spawn in basically a end portal, because we don't really want to be spending like 3 years trying to find the end portal. And to be totally honest, I don't have time enough to do that. Like if I had time, and I don't know, I reckon it would probably get boring in the end. So we can throw out like 20 blaze powder or whatever it would take, so that we don't have that blaze powder to make potions. But you know, I just feel like it would just be way too tedious, and I left all my stuff up there, didn't I? Yep. Sweet, I like the sound effects. I think sound packs are going to be handy though. I like them, but then again, I don't really like them. I think that they sounded probably a little bit animated, like weird. Alright. Yes, I know I just said that the like sounds sound animated, but you know. I'll get out of the water here. You watch, it'll be a dead end. And the fun begins. Actually, you know what? F5, F3. Alright, so we're at Y level 37, and I'm glad I broke that block. Open this. I opened up a new dead end to the cave. Really appreciative of that one. Actually, we'll go back down here, so we don't have to mine down as much. And right here, I suppose, we'll start mining down to probably Y level 8. And then, I suppose, we'll just start strip mining, trying to get diamonds, or... I don't really want to strip mine, because that does get boring then. I'd rather just go cave exploring, but my cave luck in this world has not been too great so far. Like, this cave, it's pretty big, but, like, it's, like, just not good. Like, there's been enough iron and coal, but that's it, and it's, like, hasn't gone lower than Y level 30 or whatever, and, okay, if you listen, you can hear water. You can definitely hear water. Right there. Pick up the water, please. Ooh, okay, that looks good. That looks good. Oh, we're 24 now? 23. Around 20. 20 plus, basically. We'll go this way, go down some more. I believe that diamonds, oh, let me reduce that, ore spawning will still be the same. So, yeah. Okay, we've got enough to make an anvil now. Anvil. But we're going to want to get some more so that we can make spare armor and all that good stuff. So, we want 5 diamonds, plus we're going to want a couple more than that. To hopefully make some diamond armor. Or maybe a diamond sword. Haven't quite decided yet. We'll grab the redstone for levels. And we water bucket that. And there's no diamonds in there. Well, on the surface. I don't really want to go jumping in the lava right now. Because we're making some progress, and I'd rather not have to lose all of that progress. That's what I'm kind of thinking of, just chucking down a chest and putting a chunk of iron in it as a safe guard, but, you know, that would require, like, work and thinking, and, you know, I don't think I'm in the mood for that sort of stuff. Keep grabbing a little bit of iron here and there. We're going to want to grab some more coal in a second, because we don't have too much of that left, and we'll keep making torches. Alright, that's just like a loop around. Okay, we're too high once again to find diamonds, but we do need a lot of lapis, so I'll accept this generous gift with open arms. 30 lapis. Because I went mining the other day on a particular world. And I found almost a stack of diamonds. And like 13 lapis. And that's not just like the blocks. Ores, that's like after you mine the ores. Try to find where this is coming from. Kind of feels like up over here. Okay, let's just keep going. Like, the water's coming from, like, this way, and the zombie's coming from that way. Now there's lava coming from the right as well. And our pick just broke on us. Is it just me? Or does that crafting table, when it's in your inventory, look like squished. Look, when we pick this up, we have a look at it. It just matters that looks squished. I think I may have just found a glitch as well. If you pull, so you got your pickaxe out, you pull your axe out and start hitting something. Not. Oh yeah, okay, so if you break a block whilst your thing, like your weapon or tool or whatever it is coming up, I think automatically appears. See? That's kind of cool, I suppose. I don't know if that's a glitch or if it's meant to be in the game or what. Didn't want to place two there, that's for sure. Oh, there's the lava and the gold. Sweet. Alright, we'll jump over here. I'll make more sticks. More torches. Okay, and chuck down. We actually won't use a torch there. Just iron. I am looking like on the bottom little glitchy pixel of the lava for any signs and traces of diamonds in case you yell at me for that. Get the redstone just for XP. Level 10. That's cool. Alright, we'll go this way now then, I suppose. We'll go grab this coal here. Alright, we'll go back the other way now. Oh, that's a nice move. Lapis, redstone, iron, gold. This is a nice little area for mining, I must say. Oops. I just remembered. My quartz is still on. Oh well. I'll need it to stay in. Yeah, whatever. Alright, so. If you want to find out the seed. And you want to play this map too. There's the seed. Right there. So just chuck that into your world and you can play this map too. Don't know why you'd want to. But. You can if you want. It's pretty cool. Alright, so I actually, when I first, like, loaded up 1.9, the first world I created, I literally spawned in a village that had, like, 8 obsidian and 3 diamonds, which is really cool. And I was actually thinking of using that seed for this map, but then I said it's more fun like this. We get to talk and, yeah. Shift is hidden. FPS. Alt. Alt. Oh well. That was my stomach, if you heard that. That was very loud. Apparently, my stomach wants food. And I fed it like 4 hours ago. It's ridiculous. Okay, so let's go down this way then. Whee. More iron. And that just goes up. Grab one side of this iron. That's enough. So we're not grabbing the entire veins and stuff. We're just stockpiling, because we don't want to spend 3 years just mining as a skeleton, and I do not want to fight that. You all saw how the last skeleton fight went. Like that. Shield. Okay. That fight there went a lot better. Okay. Thought I saw diamonds. Egg. Alright, so Mine this here, piece of gold. Nice, there's another gold underneath it. We'll grab that one too. Alright, and we'll get out of here. Alright, we'll probably turn that off. Okay, now that is cool. I think I'll keep that there. Up and, you know, useful. Because that's handy. That is really handy. I like that a lot. Now, my question is, if you had a lava bucket and a water bucket in, like, each hand, what would happen when you right-click? Would it, like, give you obsidian? Would it just place obsidian where you clicked? Or what would happen? That's just my question. Like that. And there goes my water. That's upsetting a little bit. Luckily, there's water all around the place. Get our torches out instead, because now that bucket's useless. Oh, I just remembered a while back in the cave system, we just left a whole bunch of golden lapis just lying there. That's a shame. I'll grab that back. Don't want to waste our precious torch. We'll grab three more pieces, why not? Okay, we'll keep running this way then, and this way, and that was close. That could have ended pretty badly, if you ask me. Nearly as badly as that. Alright, so there's something here nearby. Also, you can no longer right-click with a sword, in case you did not know that. That's why they added shields. And I think you should be able to enchant shields. There's also a new enchant called Frostwalker that you can put on your boots. And whatever water you walk on, it turns it to ice. And when you walk away, it turns back to water. Alright, so we want to be able to access this here water. Thank you. Okay, so put that away. I'll block this off. And just like that. Oops, that almost did bad. Boom. Okay, and full. Oh, back up to 35 here. This is bad. Skeleton strafe. Right now, I believe. Actually, they just strafe whichever way they want, I suppose. I should say if they strafe a lot. Whereas they just stand there rapid firing at you. Now they strafe and rapid fire. Which is really annoying. I think they need to work on the, like, animation and coding of that. Walking though, because it looks very buggy right now. If you have not seen it, alright, so. Mind you, we've fought three skeletons now. One of them, like, killed us in three hits, and let's just settle with that. Too powerful. Oh, they've just been regained their status. That is for sure. This being the most annoying. And now it starts to thunder and lightning. that failed. Okay, I don't like the looks of that. Oh, I tried to right click to block the damage and... forgot that it doesn't work anymore. That could have ended bad. Thankfully, the fast regen and all that sort of stuff helped to secure my life. And we'll chuck down that. Oops, that didn't work. Okay, let's see. And are there diamonds? I really wish I had Optifine now to zoom in on stuff. You almost forget how much you miss mods like that. Okay. Go through here now. More thunder and lightning. Sweet. Alright then. Oh, there's gold over there. I'm gonna go grab some of that. And we'll block this here off in its own little corner. Chuck the torch down. And we'll mine this here up. Oh, that was close. Sweet, so still on Y level 12. So we'll mine up this here. So now we might just have to start strip mining, because so far cave exploring has not done us much good. Maybe the, you know, rarity of diamonds has increased. Not entirely sure. One, two. Alright, so this is going to be the most effective way at of strip mining, so lucky we have got a large sum of iron to pay for the amount of iron blocks we're going to be breaking. I'd like to know what's right there. Whether it's just a cave or what. Oops, that was an accident. Okay, we'll break that. We'll go out there, because I don't... because I think this is on the other side of where we were a second ago, so... it definitely is. We'll mine up the redstone, grab the XP from it. That's really loud now. Music and sound. Ambient environment. There's subtitles as well. Now that is cool. Unfortunately, I don't need subtitles. Because I am not deaf and I can use my headphones right now. So. Yes, guys, facts about Armadillo. He is not deaf. Although he hardly ever hears that creeper that walks up behind him. I know you might think that it is surprising, but really it's not. Alright, so where's this new stack of cobble there? We'll drop that out, because we don't want that either. One, two. Alright, so still at Y level... yeah, Y level 10. So we'll continue here mining. And hopefully here soon, we can find ourselves some diamonds. So this here is going to be the most effective way of, well, mining, basically. For like the least amount of durability, I suppose. We could possibly go down a couple blocks and then like mine up as well every two blocks. But you know, we might do that eventually, but you know, not right now. Right now, I suppose we just continue mining. Which apparently is taking forever. More lava. Thought that was gravel for a second. The gravel looks a lot like andesite. Diorite, sorry. I thought I got it wrong. Andesite's like the stone looking stuff, and granite. I always get granite right. I just get these two mixed up. Because I actually know what, like, you know, granite is in real life, whereas this stuff, not so much. Diorite and andesite. I've heard of diorite, but not andesite. And I've never seen either of them, so. You know. Alright, in a second here, yeah, we're going down some. We'll go down to Y level 6. So I don't like my luck right now. Alright, we'll just mine these out, because you never know. Never know what you might miss. As they say, better safe than sorry. Nope. Ugh, this is frustrating now. Where are the diamonds? Like, I know the diamonds aren't common, but beginning to fear that diamonds don't actually even spawn anymore. Yeah, a legend of the past. And, oh, diamonds. Yes. Yes. I wasn't saying anything important, don't worry. Alright. Okay, let's get mine over here. One. Come on, please. Two. Okay. Three. Four, okay. 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, this is an amazing vein of diamonds. All right, let's start mining it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, I can't even pick them up. Oh no. I will keep the arrows, gunpowder. We don't need redstone. We'll just keep one stack of redstone for the brewing of potions to extend stuff and things. But you don't really need to extend anything except for fire res. I suppose we can use fire res when we're in the Nether. I don't know. You don't get lit on fire in the end overly much. I can state that for sure. Okay, we'll make two pickaxes this time. And, well, I should have made one of them into a diamond pickaxe. Which is what I'm going to do now. Diamond pickaxe, we can drop dirt. And more torches. Yes. And I forgot about the crafting table. Now we can drop the diorite. Then after that we'll drop the granite, I suppose. Alright, so on our way back, so we've got 1, 2, and then we'll have 3 spare diamonds. So hopefully, if we can find us one more spare vein of one more vein of diamonds, that would be really nice. And hopefully, it'll be a vein of 5, and we can make a chest plate. But otherwise, we'll have to make do with what we can get. I just remembered the Nether fortresses. They have a decent amount of chests in them, which then give you diamonds. That's not a bad idea, I must say. We'll mine this way. We'll see. Okay, we'll finish off like two more. Like, after this, we'll go two more sets. And then we'll probably go back and start mining up the obsidian and planning our attack on the Nether. Okay, sweet. Right, so one more after this. I know that this is technically the second one, but I've got an addiction. I'm sorry. Okay, and this here should probably, I suppose, be the last one. And nope. Oh, we also forgot to be mining up. Suppose we can do that on the way back. Doubt we'll be finding anything much, but you know, better safe than sorry. Some redstone. Oops, here. Yeah. Oops, ah. Okay, and here. Oh, also some new information is that when you shift now, you're 1.8 blocks high, so that's useful for really nothing and nothing at all. Actually, I believe it is useful to making like an open doorway that, like, you know, you can go through but other mobs can't, so you can make an open doorway that only players can go through, because zombies and skeletons won't be able to, because they're too fat. I will chuck this here down, right there. We'll chuck the torch in, and we're clearly going to need some more inventory space. Okay, what will we drop? Instant health. It's probably like the least useful thing right now. So we, 1, 2, 3. We'll keep some of the cobblestone, sugarcane. Just chuck that there. And cook up the rest of the beef. Okay. So that there clears up a split in our inventory, which is useful. Alright, so we are going to save 4 of these for making a enchant table. I suppose we'll do some enchanting before we go to the Nether. That could be nice. Boom. Okay, and okay, so we'll grab this here and turn a lot of these into paper, which we can then turn into books. And then we can turn that there into a enchanting table. Enchanter. We'll chuck it over there. Okay. Also, the water's here for when this year. When this year happens, but no, nah, because when it's so it just sets the obsidian laugh underneath it into obsidian, and then you actually don't lose the obsidian to burning or anything, which is really helpful. And you know, if you mine in a smart manner, it will push you around so you don't actually have to move at all. So you can just sit here with your finger on the mining button and you can just move. So what I'll do here is mine this one here, then I'll move one, and then I'll mine the block to the left, and then it'll move me into like a little circle sort of thing. See, like so, but ran out of power. So. Okay, we'll mine this here, and we need 1, 2, 3, 6. So we need 10 blocks, but there's already going to be like a couple down, so we'll grab this last one, and I think we should be good, because we'll leave, we'll just build it down here. And so, yeah. Boom. Okay, we'll chuck in some, all this iron here. Oops, and enchanting. Alright, let's see. Boom. Protection, protection, protection. Sword, let's see what we get. Knockback one. Actually, you know what, I'm going to make us up a diamond sword. Oops. Let's just check something here. Okay, that's 1.6. Which is attack speed, so that stays the same. This here is one more damage. And one attack speed. This here is 0.9, so 1.6 and 1. So every 0.6 seconds this attacks. So this attacks 0.6 seconds faster than this one here, I suppose. And then 9 attack damage, 6 attack damage. This one here attacks more than half faster than this one. So the iron sword is better. I feel really bad right now. I really feel like throwing that in the lava, but I'm not going to. Okay. Yeah, no, so even this one here is better than that there. Ugh, my life right now. Ooh, that's cool. That's handy. Wish I had a diamond sword to put that on. Alright, so we'll put prop 1 on our armor, that's for sure. On breaking. We actually will eventually need a bow, so. Okay, we'll drop. We grab some of this here stuff. And we'll do that. And we won't throw out this because we might actually eventually need it. I will drop the cobblestone over here. And we'll grab off the boots. Prop 1, we'll take that. Projectile. Chuck these on. Aqua affinity. Projectile protection. What about the books? Efficiency 1. Nope. I'm breaking 1. Nope. Ugh. Aqua affinity? Nice, that was a lucky and shit. Prop 1. Sweet. Right, let's see, what do we get? Power 1, that's what we want on that. What else do we get? Power one, that's also what we want. Power one. Okay, there we go, and that's pretty sweet. So what we're going to do is we need a couple more levels actually. And suppose we'll drop that one there. And we'll probably drop the instant health soon. I was going to do something important. Oh, we actually don't have enough to make three, right? Oh, yeah, no, we don't. Make the anvil. One, two, three. And we won't smelt down any of the gold yet. Because, yeah. Actually, it might be a smarter idea to smelt down all of the gold, but oh well. For three levels, we can get efficiency 2. Sharpness 1, why not? Efficiency 1, I'm breaking 1. I'm breaking 1, efficiency 1. Okay, there we go. And why the hell not, whilst we're sitting around, there we go, and chuck that there down. Okay, let's go looking for spiders, hopefully over here somewhere. In the cave, we'll be able to find one. I hear a skeleton. Oh, there he is. I thought he took damage from hitting me. Dang. That was unfortunate. We can get bows in the nether, but I want to have a bow before we go, sort of. Okay, because the bow is going to be really useful against the Ender, like, it's going to be essential against the Ender Dragon. And, yeah. So I've got some clue as to how to defeat the Ender Dragon and his new attacks. I don't know it all. I actually hardly know. I really don't know much of it, but yeah, I'll just settle with a little bit. Okay, so grab this, drink it up, chuck that out, mine all this up, okay, so 1, 2, 3, and here, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so struggles of life. Alright, let one of those smelt quickly. And we'll turn this here into flint and steel, light up the portal, we'll grab our enchanting table. Oh, spider. Where's this spider coming from? That's what I really want to know. From up here somewhere, is it? Doesn't seem like it. No. Spider. Mr. Spidey. Okay, don't know where Mr. Spidey is. So. Run back down here. Okay, so it's around here somewhere. Okay, so this here is out of mine. Come on, Mr. Spidey, you're around here somewhere. I know you. I know you were. Okay, where are you, Mr. Spidey? Where is he? Ah, that's really close. There we go. Hopefully this guy will drop us 3 string or such. Okay, that's 2, that's definitely 2. No string, really? No, that's just disappointing. Alright, nice, there's another spider. No string again? Oh, that's really unfortunate. I really wanted a bow, especially before we went into the nether, because we need one before we fight the ender dragon, that's for sure. So, you know, the sooner the better, really, because then I can get these 3 books out, 2 books out of my inventory and clear up a bit of space. Alright then, let's keep going. Eat up our steak. We'll mine up this here, lappies. Anyway, once we enter the nether here, levels shouldn't be a problem at all because of the quartz. So, yeah. Now we need to find where we came from. Which is probably going to be the hard part. Considering we're lighting this section here up, I'm assuming we didn't come from that way. There's a strip mine here. Okay, so that's where we came down. Okay, so we didn't come past there, I'm pretty sure. Let's go this way, this way. Oh, we did not come from up there. Okay, we came from around here, I remember this now. Do we come from down here? Yes. Okay, there we go, and we came from the opposite direction. Oh, there. Alright, we'll grab this. I'll preserve the wood, I will drop out that. And F. Right, let's go. Right, -220 and -190. Okay, we need to go deeper. Sweet, we got that achievement. Oh, okay, let's hope. Hope we get a good spawn here, guys. Okay, hit shift. Right click. Alright, we seem safe enough. This does not look like an overly good spawn though, unfortunately. Alright, bit of block lag there. First, trying to load in everything, I suppose. Right, we'll just type in our coords right here, right now. -23, -17, -27. Sweet, that's easy enough chords. We got them written down so we won't lose them. And now we can just go for a little jog. Nothing over here. Alright, we'll go back to the portal here then, and we'll just mine straight up. We'll use the iron pick, try and break these guys down, and hopefully preserve a diamond pick a little bit more. Okay, here's pigmen. up and to the right here. Ooh, straight up now. Right above me. Okay, let's hope that pigmen are peaceful mobs until you actually do hit one. So that is good hope to have. Okay. All right, let's just double back here a bit. I did hit pigmen back here, and now I don't hear pigmen anymore. So. Okay, let's keep going. Hopefully we'll find something eventually. Pretty positive though if we just strip mine here out a bit. That scared me. Something, no. Thought there was like a lava drip or something, but no, there's nothing. Right, let's just go back here to where we first heard the pigmen and see if we can find anything. I know it was back here a little bit more, but don't know. Alright, it was right down here. Oh, there. I thought that was the first block I broke. Okay. I hear our portal. Oh, fire this way. Oh, big man. This is confusing me now. Okay, there's a ghast. Definitely a ghast. Okay. Alright, sorry for having the shield on. I know it makes it like really obnoxious and it covers up a lot of the screen. I'm just really scared right now. I don't want to die at all whilst I'm in the nether. Okay, there's the fire we were hearing. Oh. Damn it. Alright, let's just explore out a little bit. Here's the pigmen. Right, so pigmen are friendly, that's nice. Okay, I did hear a ghast, but yeah, I'm not sure where. Not sure where that fella is. We'll try and mine up this way. Hopefully we'll be able to find something. Not too sure on my luck though, so. Yes. That's definitely a close ghast. Ooh, and if we can. Oh, I really wish I had a bow right now. So if we could have killed this ghast, we could get the gas tears and oh, that was scary. Yeah, it's just a one block a lava source thing. All right then, so give me a second, gotta do some stuff and I'll be right back.